Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to integrate strategic models using Groovy rules. Oracle supports the creation of business rules written in the Groovy scripting language. You can create Groovy rules that can dynamically generate calculation scripts at runtime based on context, then execute the calculation against SBase. For example, the rule will capture product volume and calculate monthly product revenue. You can also create rules that can perform data validations and opt to cancel operations if the data entered violates company policies. For example, the rule can change the background color of data cells and forms if data is missing or prevent users from saving data based on a condition. You can also create rules that integrate data between planning cubes and models. Similar to business rules, you create Groovy rules in Calculation Manager. Then, you run these Groovy rules from any place a calculation script rule can be executed. On the Rules page, within the context of a form, using Job Scheduler, in Dashboards, Task Lists, or using EPM Automate. You can also include Groovy rules in Business Rule Sets. You can have a combination of calculation scripts and Groovy rules within a rule set. For technical reference in designing Groovy rules, see the Java API reference for Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud Groovy Rules in the Cloud Help Center. The Java API reference includes examples that demonstrate the syntax and power of the EPM Groovy object model. Let's take a look at a few examples. Notice the empty cells in this form. I'll implement a Groovy rule that changes the background color of data cells based on specified conditions. In Calculation Manager, Groovy rules are designed in script mode. The script type should be set to Groovy script. Here's my script. The cell background color is set using hexadecimal color codes. The script begins by going over each data cell in the current data grid. The it variable refers to the current data cell returned by the data cell iterator. The conditions and actions performed are specified in the following sections. The if statement begins by checking a cell for missing, not zero values using the cell.missing property. If the data cell value is missing, the background color is set to blue. If the data cell is less than or equal to 50,000, the background color is set to orange. If the data cell value is greater than 50,000, the background color is set to green. I'll save and deploy this rule. Next, I'll edit the form and add the Groovy rule to run after loading the form. After saving, I'll open the form in a simplified interface. With the Groovy rule running after loading the form, the background color for data cells are set depending on the conditions in the rule. Now, let's take a look at Groovy rules that push data between planning cubes and models. Our company uses a custom navigation flow that includes those tasks. Here are the standard strategic model cards. Here are the custom cards that we use when we perform data integrations. Before we begin, I'll show you the data point of view we'll be working with. I'll move data from my source planning cube to a model. After running the Groovy rule that pushes the data to a model, we'll be able to validate that the data was moved using this tab. In Calculation Manager, I'll open the Groovy rule we'll use to sync data and go over some of the sections. In summary, our rule performs the following tasks. Get the planning cube, define the region we'll be working with, and build the data grid definition. Next, build the planning grid and collect data into a data array based on the data grid definition. Then, we form the strategic model grid based on the planning grid and include calculations. Finally, we take what we just constructed and save it to our strategic model. Let's take a closer look. The script begins by using getCube to get the planning cube which the data will be loaded from. We use a data grid definition builder for that cube to construct the grid definition in our selected data region. Just like a planning form, we assign elements to the POV, column, and row to the grid definition. This section asks the builder to build the data grid definition object. Here, we define a data array for storing data. Next, we load data to the planning grid based on our grid definition. We use the withClosable method to ensure that the grid's close method is invoked after all the code within a closure is executed. This releases system resources associated with the grid. Here, we define a scaling factor. Scaling factors are optional. In this case, we need a scaling factor because our strategic model's units are in millions. Groovy script writes and reads data values as ones from the model. This is where we iterate over the grid object and retrieve values one cell at a time and store it into our data array. Then, the planning grid is closed. Now we start by getting our strategic model grid, making sure we use the withClosable method. We use the data grid builder for that model to construct the data grid for the region we want to push data to. To build the data grid, data is taken from the data array and pushed into a data region. You can perform data adjustments in this section. For strategic models, the POV can contain only scenario members. The column can contain time dimension members, and the row should contain account members and optionally custom dimension members. Once all the data is gathered, we run the build method against the grid builder object and include a status object. This is where the strategic model grid with data is built. Then save the data in the grid to the strategic model. And the strategic model data grid and strategic model are closed. I'll deploy the rule so that we can run it from the form. I'll verify that the Groovy business rule is associated with the form where I am running the rule. Here's my Groovy business rule. Let's go back to the sync bottom-up plan form. Take note of the data on this form. I'll launch the business rule from the Actions menu. I'll verify that the data was pushed on the Strategic Plan tab. Our strategic model now contains data from planning. Let's move on to our next task. Push model data into our planning cube. Here's the data point of view we'll be working with. Here's my source POV and my target POV. I'll go back to Calculation Manager and open the Groovy rule we'll use for this task. Similar to the previous script, we need to build grid definitions and data grids prior to pushing the data and saving it to planning. The script begins by setting variables. Here we map the model's time period to the planning year dimension members. Then, we define the account names we will be pushing data to. This line collects the list of strategic model time periods we mapped. This line collects the list of planning years we mapped. Then, we start working on our strategic model grid definition and data grid. Here, we get the strategic model while including the withClosable method. Here, we use the data grid definition builder for that model to construct the grid definition on our selected data region. And build the strategic model data grid, again, using the withClosable method. Next, we perform similar steps where we define the planning grid and push the data that we collected. Here's our region. Here, we push data from the strategic model to the planning grid one row at a time. We also used a scaling factor in this script. While building the planning grid, a status option is included to display the number of cells accepted and rejected. When completed, data is saved to planning. And the planning data grid, strategic model data grid, and strategic model are closed. I'll deploy this rule and return to the push targets card in strategic modeling. I'll run the rule using the actions menu. Data was successfully moved from my strategic model to my planning application. In this tutorial, you learned how to integrate strategic models using Groovy rules. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.